sketching his idea on a cocktail napkin, Grodin proposed a series of tanks lined up like enormous underground wells. As the concrete was poured, workers had to quickly remove the shoring before the rising tide swept it under.
Kenny and Yunji, Peter says the fuel leak at Red Hill may be much more than the 27,000 gallons the Navy originally reported.
Expert testimony today called into question the Navy's ability to monitor corrosion and catch fuel leaks at its storage facility at Red Hill.
Today's sworn testimony included several experts questioning the Navy's testing techniques of the integrity of its 20 fuel tanks and the Navy's overall ability to monitor them. Witnesses at the hearing focused on two recent fuel leaks in particular that combined thousands of gallons of fuel released May 6th and November 20th.
I'm here to ask why in May of this year that pipeline released not 1,000 gallons as originally indicated, but 1,618 gallons, of which greater than 60 were not captured.
The Department of Health's lawyer painting a picture of the Navy's inability to keep up with tank inspection. Tank number 11 going 40 years without a full inspection.
Now, the Navy says it's sorry for the November leak that contaminated drinking water, servicing 93,000 people along its water line, but it refuses to drain the fuel.
The Navy claims it was able to account for and reclaim the vast majority of discharged fuel in regards to the May spill, though some testifying say the Navy's numbers just don't add up.